students, so here are some of other problems and other definitions. We have to go through the probability. So the other definitions are finite sample space. So finite sample space means a sample space is called as a finite sample space if it contains sample points are finite. So if it is countable, then it is called as a finite sample space. If it is uncountable, then it is called as an infinite sample space. Next, she has given a problem, two dice are thrown. We already know that if dice is thrown two times, then we are having a formula 6 squared that equal to 36 elements. Then he has given A be an event that sum of points on the faces is 9. So A means he has given sum of points. If you add two points, then we get 9. Next, B be an event that at least one number is 6. Then he has asked this 6. So now we are going to do that. So we already know that when a die is rolled n times, we are having a formula 6 power n. So when a die is rolled 2 times, we have a formula 6 squared that equal to 36 elements. So A, he has given A. A means what he has asked, what he has given means sum of the points on the faces is 9. So 3, 6, if we add, we get 9. 4, 5, we get 9. 5, 4, we get 9. And 6, 3, we get 9. So number of favorable case of getting A is 4. Next, second B. He has given that B is an event that at least one number is 6. So at least one number is 6, we are having 11 cases in out of 36 cases. So here probability of A is 4 by 36 that equal to 1 by 9 and the probability of B is 11 cases 11 by 36. Now we have to find P of A intersection. So intersection means we already know that the common elements. So the common elements between A and B are 3, 6 and 6. So we are having 2 elements. So 2 by 36 that equal to 1 by 18. Next P of A union B. A union B means we have to write one time this all, or we already know that the formula for A union B by using the addition theorem is P of A union B can be written as P of A plus P of B minus P of A intersection B. So on substituting these values we get 13 by 36. Next P of A intersection B component. This is by using the De Morgan's law we can simply prove that by taking P of A minus P of A intersection B. We already know that the value of P of A. So that is 4 by 36, P of A intersection B is 2 by 36, we get 2 by 36. So similarly P of A complement intersection B. So that means it can be written as P of B minus P of A intersection B. So we already know that P of B is 11 by 36 minus 2 by 36 that is equal to 9 by 36. So similarly P of A complement intersection B complement. That means since by De Morgan's law we can write it as P of A union B whole complement. That means it can be written as 1 minus P of A union B. That means 1 minus 13 by 36 that is equal to 23 by 36. So hence it is complete. So by using the De Morgan's we have done this. Next, A complement union B complement. This can be written as A intersection B whole complement. So this can be written as 1 minus P of A intersection B. Already we know that the value of A intersection B is 2 by 36. So on subtracting this from 1, we get 17 by 8. So this is the solution for the given problem. So similarly, he has given 150 students. Total number of students are 150. Next, 80 are studying maths. So probability of 80 are studying maths is 80 by out of 150 students, so 80 by 150. Next, 40 are studying physics. So B means studying physics. So P of B equal to 40 by 150. 30 are studying maths and physics. That means intersection. So intersection between physics and maths is 30. So P of A intersection B is 30. So he is asked if a student is chosen at random, then find the probability that the student studying maths or physics, or means we have to take union. Students studying neither maths nor physics. That means A complement intersection B complement we have to find. So now I am going to find that. So already I know that by using the probability theorem of addition theorem of probability, I already know that P of A union B can be written as P of A plus P of B minus P of A intersection B. So on substituting the given values, I have an answer that is 3 by 5. Next, P of A complement intersection B complement. This can be written as P of A union B whole complement. That means 1 minus P of A union B. So we get 2 by 5. So this is the answer for that. So next problem is 60 boys and 20 girls are there in a class. That means total number of students in a class is the 60 plus 20. That is equal to 80. All the boys, that means 60 boys will play cricket. And half of the girls play cricket. That means half means the half of 20 is 10. That means 20 girls, out of 20 girls, 10 girls will play cricket. Find the probability of selected person to be a boy or a girl who plays cricket. Or means we already know that we have to find P of A union B. Here P of A intersection B is 5. Why? Because getting both boy and girl at a time is not possible. So it is not possible. So it is mutually exclusive. That means A intersection B is 5. So A intersection B value is 5. So P of A union B equal P of A plus P of A. On substituting these values we get 7 by 8. So this is the answer for the given problem. So similarly, we can do the same model problems here. I have done the same problems here. So what is the probability that a card drawn at random from pack of playing cards may be either queen or a king? So already know that I am having the the cards are 52 cards. So out of 52 cards, there are 4 queen cards and 4 king cards. So here also A intersection B equal to 5. Why means getting both king and queen card both at a time is not possible. That means at one card getting both is not possible. So A intersection B equal to 5. So A intersection B value 5. On substituting these two values, we get answer. So that is 2 by 13. So 2 by 13 is the answer for the given problem. So similarly, he has given a problem here. So this is also an important problem. So this 28th problem is a problem in statistics is given to 3 students. That is ABC, whose chances of solving it are 1 by 2, 3 by 4 and 1 by 4. So what he has asked is, what is the probability that the problem is solved if all of them try independently? So all of them try independently means we have to do P of A union B union C we have to do. So now I am taking P of A, probability of A as probability that A to solve a problem. Probability of B as probability of B as B to solve a problem. Probability of C as C to solve a problem. So I already know that P of A equal to 1 by 2, P of B equal to 3 by 4 and P of C equal to 1 by 4. So now this can be written in two ways. So there are two methods for solving this type of problems. So the one method is we can simply use the formula. So that is P of A union B union C equal to P of A plus P of B plus P of C minus P of A intersection B minus P of B intersection C minus P of A intersection C plus P of A intersection B intersection C. So this is the formula for addition theorem of three methods. So simply we have to substitute the given values in this, then we get the simple answer like this. So the answer is 29 by 32. Or there is an alternative method for doing this problem. So that is P of A union B can be, A union C can be written as 1 minus P of A union B union C whole complement. So that equal to 1 minus P of A complement intersection B complement intersection C complement. That means P of A complement intersection means into P of B complement into P of C complement. So P of A complement can be written as 1 minus P of A, P of B complement can be written as 1 minus P of B, P of C complement can be written as 1 minus P of C. So 1 minus P of A is 1 by 2, 1 minus P of B that equal to 3 by 4, 1 minus P of C that equal to 1 by 4. So on substituting these values, we get the answer 29 by 32 is the answer for the given problem. So these are the two methods for solving this type of problems. So I have done the problem, same similar problem I have done here. So you can see that problem. So here also I have done the problem. So the next definition is conditional probability. So conditional probability means if A and B are two events in a sample space, yes, and P of A not equal to 0, here the denominator should not be equal to a 0, then P of B by A represents the occurrence of B when event A has already occurred. That means P of B by A equal to P of A intersection B by P of A, where P of A is not equal to 0. That means P of B by A represents occurrence of B when event A has already occurred. That means P of B by A can be written as P of A intersection B by P of A, where this P of A is not equal to 0, then it is called as a definition for conditional problem. Or similarly, we can write like this also. That means P of A by B equal to P of A intersection B by P of B. So this also we can write. So this is the definition of a conditional problem. So the next definition is independent events. We already know that two events A and B are said to be independent if P of A intersection B equal to P of A into P of B. Next definition is mutually independent events. So we can say that A1, A2, so on, AN are mutually independent events if P of A1 intersection A2 intersection and so on intersection AN can be written as P of A1 into P of A2 into and so on P of A into A. So the next definition is pairwise independent event. So that is condition is P of A intersection AJ can be written as P of A into AJ. So the next theorem is multiplicative theorem. So this is very very simple theorem. So the statement of this theorem is if A and B are two events of a sample space, yes, then P of A intersection B can be written as P of A into P of B by A or P of B into P of A by B. So simply we can prove this by using the conditional probability, definition of conditional probability, we can simply prove that problem. So P of B by A, we already know that by definition of conditional probability, P of A intersection B by P of A. Here, if we take this P of A intersection B this side, then P of A into P of B by A. So, this is the equation number 1. So, similarly, P of A by B can be written as like this, P of A intersection B equal to P of B into P of A by B. So, from 1 and 2, we can simply say that P of A intersection B equal to P of A into P of B by A or P of B into P of A by B. So my problem is completed. Suppose A and B are independent events. That means P of A he has given 1 by 6, P of B he has given 1 by 4. Now he has asked to find P of A union B and P of A intersection B. So he has given a condition that A and B are independent events. So we already know that P of A intersection B can be written as P of A into P of A. So on substituting these values, we get 1 by 24. Next, P of A union B, we already know that by formula of addition theorem of three events, we already know that P of A union B can be written as P of A plus P of B minus P of A intersection B. So on substituting these values, we get 3 by 8. So this is the answer for the given problem. So these are the problems on conditional problems.